by the sound of thunder crashing and lightning so bright it's filling the entire room. I sit straight up in bed and I go, oh no, please tell me this is a joke. This cannot be happening. Today is race day, a race that I've been preparing for the last 6 months. I'm in Cincinnati, Ohio with my best friend and my brother, and we're gonna run on my first marathon, the Flying Pig. What do? It's pouring the rain, it's thundering, it's lightning. We go and we get trash bags and we cut the bottom out of the trash bags and we pull them over our bodies and we head out to the race. There's 15,000 people signed up to run this race. There was actually 20,000 people signed up. 15 people actually showed up to run the race. Because of the rain, it was raining so hard, it took us longer to get to the race site than we originally expected. So we're running a little bit behind. So we get there and we end up in the very end of the race line. So it takes us 15 minutes to walk just to the point where we get to the starting line. Now we get there, it's still pitch black outside, and by this point our shoes and socks are soaked and we're squishing. And it doesn't matter, because when that gun goes off, when we take off, we are so full of adrenaline and excitement that we just take off running, right? And so we begin to take our garbage bags off and throw them off to the side of the road, and there's a plethora of garbage bags and raincoats and all this makeshift stuff where everybody else is throwing their jackets off too. And we're running. The sun begins to come up and it stops raining and we're having the time of our lives, just like we could imagine. Running this race, me, my best friend, my brother, and we're just running along. I love the Flying Pig Marathon because they have, at every mile, they have markers where there's water tables and there's entertainers. So they had cheerleaders cheering us on and bands playing. It was a lot of excitement. Now this particular marathon is 6 miles of an incline out of the 13.1 that we were running that day. Six of it was going to be an incline. We had trained for this though. We were ready. We had mapped out where the inclines were, where they ended. And we knew that the last 2 miles was going to be all downhill. So if we could just get to mile 11, we had it. We were good. So we're heading up the very last hill. We come to the top, and it was beautiful. We're at the top of this hill, and you look out, and you see all of Cincinnati, and my brother says, there's the finish line, and we look over, and we see it, and it's like this feeling like, yes, we got it, right? We're there. We see the finish line. We have our eye on the goal. Those of you who know me know I drink a lot of water, so I see a water stand. And now, when you get to water stands when you're running races, you don't walk up and take a drink of water. You're running, and they hand you a cup of water, and you drink it, throw it, and you keep on running. So I do that. I get my water, and I'm getting back up there, keep running, and all of a sudden, I had this sharp shooting pain in my right hip. It's so intense. It stopped me for a split second, and it took my breath away. I had immense pain in my hip, and I thought, oh my goodness, what's going on? But I don't stop running. I keep going, but I'm kind of limping. And if you've ever experienced intense pain, you know when you feel the pain, it takes your breath away. And you also know that if you're a runner, you need your breath. Your breath is your lifeline. If you're not breathing while you're running, you're dying. So I'm trying to breathe while I'm trying to run through this. And my brother looks at me and he says, Rachel, are you okay? And I'm, because I'm trying to breathe. And by this point, I have tears running down my face because all I can think, my head is like playing these tricks on me, like, what's wrong? What's going on? Can you keep running? Do you need to stop? What do you do? And I'm like, I have my eye on the finish line. I'm just gonna keep going, one foot in front of the other. And he's like, you need to stop, because he sees me limping. And I'm shaking my head, no, I'm not stopping. We're just gonna keep on going. So we go, we slow down our pace. By this point, it's quiet and nobody's talking. We're passing people, and as we're passing people, I look over and I see a lady who's running, and she's got blood running down her legs. And I say, I know she's in pain, and she's still going. I'm not stopping. Because see, the voices in my head were telling me, you can stop. It's okay, you're in pain. You can stop. And I just kept thinking, no, that finish line is less than 2 miles now. I got it. We've been running a little over 2 hours. I only have a little bit of time left. I've trained so hard for this. I know I can do this. A little bit later, I'm running, I see a guy, he actually has blood running down his shirt. And I said, I know he's in pain, but he's still running. I'm gonna keep running. And so I push those little voices aside and I keep running, one foot in front of the other. We round the last corner and there's the finish line and I see it. And always when I'm training with my best friend, we run together and we talk. Every time I see like where our ending point is, I have a bad habit or a good habit of like picking up the pace because I'm just ready to get done. And if you're running for 2 hours, 3 hours, you're just like, you're just ready to be done. I was just ready to be done this particular time. And so I see that finish line and it was a lot farther than I thought it was. You know, your mind plays tricks on you. So I see this finish line and I start picking up my pace while I'm looking. And my best friend tells me later, she's like, your brother looked at me and was like, what is she doing? And she's like, I don't know, let's just go with it. So they come behind me and we're running. And I pick up my pace and I'm running so fast because I'm just trying to get to that finish line. I cross that finish line and there's a lady standing there. Somebody said it for me. And she takes this medallion and she puts it around my neck. And in that moment, I was just crying so hard because I was so proud that I just kept putting one foot in front of the other. I just kept going. When it got tough and when my mind was telling me to quit, it didn't matter how much pain I was in. I just kept going. And it was so worth it. And so tonight, what I want to leave you with is life is hard. Life is difficult. Life is going to knock you down. And when it does, put one foot in front of the other and just keep going. Surround yourself with people who are going to inspire you and motivate you and don't ever give up because your dream is so important. And when you reach it, you're going to feel that feeling of empowerment and excitement that you have never experienced before. Don't ever give up. Keep your eye on the finish line.